Hey everybody, and welcome back to Vestanland. This is episode 14, and in this episode, I do a little bit of expansion of the neighborhood I worked on earlier. I add a new school complex, which I imagine is sort of a K-12 kind of secondary and primary school at one, and I add some sort of modern infill development around it. And then kind of the second half and probably most important part of the episode is I create a new highway interchange on the very western edge of the main island. And that connects to the outside connections, which are further away on the map. I'm pretty happy with how it turns out. Again, that part is in the second half of the episode. And before I get to it, I have to fill in a little bit of development just in kind of some of these blocks that I talked about earlier. Not much different than some of the stuff I've been doing in previous episodes, so I'm not going to talk on it too much. A lot of the same strategies I've been using throughout the series, sort of splicing these buildings together to create a more cohesive look. I'm sort of struggling with this area. You'll sort of see moving forward. There's this part north of this main boulevard. I don't end up filling in this episode because I wanted to sort of transition it, hopefully, to sort of a lower density, but I wasn't sure which assets to use. So I think I'm going to sort of bypass that for the time being and move on to it at a later time because there's a few more specific projects that I want to get into, and I want to do episodes based on that rather than some of the infill, which just gets a little bit tedious and repetitive. Speaking of tedious and repetitive, this is basically the start to finish of me using intersection marking tool on this major junction right here. I do a lot of work like this, but I figured I'd put in a example of me sort of the whole process of one of these intersections, I should say. Again, this is some of the more satisfying stuff to watch, I think. So hopefully you guys enjoy kind of this start to finish time lapse. Let me know what you think about this. I think it looks pretty cool, especially with the bike lanes and the tram markings and stuff like that. A lot going on. Anyway, this is the school complex that I mentioned earlier. I sort of used the same strategy as I did with the medical center in the previous episode. I placed down a bunch of different assets that I had, try to get a sense of what would fit best in this space. I decided to go with sort of a modern look for these buildings. This is actually mainly Asian assets. I think the two ones I put in the middle are from Hong Kong, and then the one with the green roof is Japanese. And then the other one you can see, I'll slide it to place here in a second, is just sort of a generic modern elementary school. All of these are currently, at least in-game, functioning as elementary schools, but off-camera, I change them around so that they function as elementary and high schools, because I'm imagining that's what this is. Now I'm sort of detailing this little side area. First, I start out by flattening the terrain. I guess I should say before I get to that, I do some terraforming just to kind of justify why the development stops where it does on this island. There's kind of this, not really mountain range, but this hillside, which is pretty steep, which would have inhibited development, and it kind of makes sense that more modern development is closer to where it starts getting steeper. Maybe there was some logging industry or something like that, which prevented sort of the sort of older style development that we'd seen in the more central part of the city. And as time has gone on, more modern infill has spread to this area, and that one of those things is this school complex. You can see it's kind of representative of a new wave of development, not kind of a sort of a more modern European style. I think that makes a lot of sense for this area. Now I'm creating this little flattened out area to the side of the school with these retaining walls and terra networks. I put down a few basketball courts here. These assets are really cool. I can't remember who they're by on the workshop. These sort of different color basketball courts are really cool. They're fun to work with, and I think they add a nice touch to this area. I mentioned in previous episode how I'm getting more into the sort of backstory of this place, and I sort of decided I think sports are going to be a big factor down the line. I want to develop kind of a, I'm a couple of different stadiums and arenas in the city, and extending off of that, one of the things I want to focus on is that the sort of two main sports of the country of Vestanland are basketball and soccer, or football, as many of you may know it. I'll refer to it as soccer because as an American, that's what I think of it as, but everyone should know what that means. And yeah, hopefully that doesn't upset anybody. Unfortunately, for this little area, I lost some of the footage, so this is kind of a me kind of like, I sort of already put all these buildings down, and then I kind of just slid them back into place, or like I slid them out and back in just for the sake of the video. So yeah, you kind of get a streamlined version of the actual process. I mentioned this again in another episode, but I do like a lot of these vanilla assets, particularly the ones from the Green Cities DLC and some of the modern wall-to-wall buildings. Yeah, I also missed some of the footage of me detailing the outside of school, so that's a little cinematic shot just to show the first things that I did there. And then yeah, now I'm getting into continuing that detailing process, first by adding some decals to these kind of plaza areas, and then adding a few planters with bushes around the edge. Nothing too crazy or time consuming. Again, I don't want the series to be bogged down too much with detail, mainly because I want, as I mentioned at the start of the episode, I want to get to a lot of really cool projects down the line, and I can't do that if I focus too much on the small details on every block of the city. Yeah, that's sort of the basic philosophy. Now I'm adding some decals to this sort of central courtyard area. I would imagine this is probably a place where students come out to eat lunch. Probably is a nice area to get some fresh air between classes. Again, nothing too complicated, but I think it looks pretty cool. Now I'm using intersection marking tool to add this template to some of these streets on the sort of southern part, or the neighborhood that is just directly to the south of the school campus. I think I did it off, I guess I changed some of these roads to one-way roads just to add a little bit of variety in terms of just the traffic flow and the road markings. Now I'm adding in some sort of generic low-rise residential buildings using procedural objects as I have in previous episodes to sort of fill a weird corner. I'm using a lot of these modern Dutch-style assets in these more modern neighborhoods. The textures are really nice and they're pretty generic, so I think they fit in pretty well in this area. I didn't mention it specifically, but I added some of those low-rise commercial buildings right in front of the school, and those are basically just a few like little like, shops and stuff that maybe students would frequent during the day or just like before or after school. So a lot of those made sense. Now moving to the north of the school area, I'm doing a little more terraforming, and you'll see I'm basically forming sort of this little cliff side type thing, adding in a few of these rocks to kind of define the edge, and this is kind of going to form the barrier between the kind of dense neighborhood and then kind of the more, not rural, but like more of a like kind of nature preserve type place, because of the steep hillside above. And this, you can imagine, I can imagine the road here was probably built more recently. And yeah, for a while, that probably was just like a dirt trail or something like that, that hindered development on that part of the city. Again, this is the area that I didn't really know what to do with, so I'm sort of going to leave it for a later time. I just sort of need some inspiration to strike before I know how to fill that out. I was getting kind of tired of just placing out buildings, and I wanted to move on to a more interesting project. Speaking of more interesting projects that are going to happen down the line, as you can see, I terraformed out that really like that big flat area, and my thought process with that is that that's going to be where a lot of the, not like services, but like wastewater treatment, maybe like recycling and sewage facilities, stuff like that. There'll probably be a whole episode dedicated to that down the line. So stay tuned for that, because Those, while they're not the prettiest areas, they're super necessary for creating a realistic city like this one. So yeah, I'm looking forward to that in the future. But focusing on the present, I am getting started with this massive interchange, which I believe I made the thumbnail of this episode. This thing was a real pain to work on. All the different height differences and the pretty narrow landmass that I had left myself to work with were pretty challenging, but in the end I think I created something that looks pretty cool. It works pretty well. Yeah, you can see this is like one of many times that I still had to delete everything and start over. Eventually I decided to go with sort of a double-decker bridge type thing, and you can see me elevating this rail line just to kind of get out of the way for the time being. This highway that I'm putting to the north of the interchange is going to be basically just an industrial road, just serving like truck traffic between those facilities I mentioned earlier and the outside connections. Whereas the civilian traffic will all be directed into these two east-west roads that are already kind of major thoroughfares in the city. I eventually realized that these height differences I was trying to navigate, I was going to need to use some loops. That loop I put down there is not what ends up in the final design, but I thought I'd include footage of it anyway, especially since it also includes me putting this sort of flyover ramp going directly to the industrial area. Yeah, now you can see this is another loop that doesn't make it in to the final cut. I realize, yeah, it took a lot of trial and error to get this to work right. Getting the scale sort of realistic. Yeah, you can see this loop here, one of the more ridiculous things that I've tried to build. But then I decided to go the other way, and that looks a lot better, I think. I think that's what this loop right here is what makes this interchange look really interesting and unique, I think. Yeah, it's kind of, I hadn't really seen something exactly like this before. Yeah, let me know in the comments if this, if you think this looks cool, for one, but secondarily, if you've seen something like this, and if it's either, you know, if it's something cool or if it's like a terrible interchange that doesn't work, I don't know. But yeah, I'd love to know if this is something that would work in real life, because it looks like it works in the game. But yeah, I don't know how realistic it is necessarily, but I can't worry too much about it now. It's in the game, it's in the city, it works pretty well, as you'll see down the line here. The first time I had really used the network multi-tool function for this even slope and seeing the different like percent grades, I'd seen other people use it, but I hadn't really gotten to it myself. I'm not sure why I didn't earlier, because it's super useful and it looks super cool to create these like nice even slopes. And it's easy to sort of identify the places where you need to make some changes and you need to sort of reroute things. Yeah, that was a super, super helpful part of this build. I'm glad I decided to use it. Another thing I used a lot of was node controller, which you've seen me use in other episodes for other projects, but it's probably the most helpful in this one to get these nodes looking at least semi-realistic. Yeah, again, I mean, some of these mods are make these types of builds possible, and I'm super grateful for them. This is another loop that I sort of playing around with. I don't end up putting this one in either. But these loops, they sort of gave me an understanding of where the height differences are great enough to require a loop, and this was not one of those places. I just decided to create a sort of more simple flyover ramp for this little area. I also realized I needed to elevate this northern highway that's not connected to anything right now, but I need to elevate that up further above sea level in order to get this interchange to work a little more easily. When I originally had it more at sea level, it was a little bit too cumbersome to deal with, so I'm glad I kind of adjusted that and made things a little bit easier for myself. I'm using Move It a ton to shift these ramps around and create some more natural looking shapes. Again, getting that loop, that's kind of the defining feature of this interchange. That's for the sort of general purpose traffic coming from the outside, going over the bridge, and then going on the road to the north of the train station. That's how people would access the medical center and the more modern neighborhoods to the city's north. Whereas traffic going into the old city would go on this sort of more southern route, which is more of a straight shot around the coast. You can also see I have the bus lane. That's the part that's kind of the most direct route between the bridge and the central city, which I thought was appropriate. That looks really cool when it's done, and I use the intersection marking tool to kind of distinguish that from the other roads, and yeah, that part looks really cool. I'm really happy with how it looks. You'll see, I guess you won't see because I didn't end up using it, but intersection marking tool, I was having some problems getting the solid fillers to show up on some of these elevated sections, so hopefully I'll be able to get that figured out, and I will add some of these details I don't get to a little bit later on, just because I couldn't get them in this episode, unfortunately. But I'm sure that whatever is happening, it's either on my end or with the mod, will get resolved. And yeah, I'll be able to fix that down the line eventually. Right now, I would like to take a moment to thank you for watching the video. If you're enjoying it, I'd encourage you to like the video and subscribe to the channel. It means a lot to me, and I really appreciate it. I appreciate you guys sticking around this long. Hope you're enjoying the video. If there's anything you like, dislike, or suggestions that you have, feel free to leave a comment down below and let me know what it is. If you want to get more involved with the series and the channel, I have a Discord server, which will be linked in the description of the video. I also have an Instagram account, which you can follow to get some more regular updates of the city. Check all those things out if you're interested in following along with Vestanland a little bit more closely. And again, thanks so much for watching. I'm putting a few more final touches on the exact placement of these ramps and leveling out some of the terrain and adding some trees just to kind of do some basic detailing. You can see when I turned on the simulation, the cars were using it as I hoped they would, which was super gratifying to see. I especially like the cars going over the flyover, down the loop, and into the city. I think that looks pretty cool. I think it looks pretty realistic too, at least realistic enough for me, which is kind of the whole idea behind the series. Now I'm getting an intersection marking tool. I mentioned earlier this was something I did a lot of for this interchange, and I'm adding some of these yellow markings to differentiate the bus lane from the rest of the roads, which I think is nice. It adds a little bit of color and looks pretty, it makes sense, I guess, practically, just to provide drivers with a sort of visual cue that they're not supposed to go on the bus lane. I'm sure there's problems with people following that rule, but you know, as is life, I suppose. There's more work to be done on this interchange. It's not completely finished by the end of this episode, which I was a little disappointed by. Just means there's a few things I have to get around to down the line in order to make it look as good as it could be. You can see I was mentioning, this is the part I think that really brings it to life when I add this red marking on the bus lane ramps going through the middle of the interchange. This looks really cool and was kind of the final thing that I needed to make this really come together. Now I'm adding some pillars under this elevated rail line that goes right through the middle of the interchange. I know for a fact that these pillars probably wouldn't be enough to support the weight of this rail corridor, but there's not really anything else I could think to do. I put enough in there that I think it looks plausible at least, which is kind of all I'm really going for. I didn't want, obviously I couldn't have the whole thing just floating, but I'm not going to be able to, at least I don't have the time or the willpower to sort of figure out how to put in enough pillars to completely support that rail line. So I apologize for that, but that's just the way it's going to be. Now, one of the last things in this episode is adding some pillars to this bridge. I'm not sure if this is kind of the final design of this bridge. I was thinking of, I initially wanted to create something a little more architecturally impressive for this crossing, but it's not a very large body of water, and the water here is pretty shallow. So I was thinking that might not have been justified. And I do have plans for a really grand bridge connecting this island with the island immediately to the north. That'll probably be pretty far down the line, but I think that might be the kind of main bridge of the city. But yeah, if you have any ideas for what this bridge could look like, any assets I could use, I'd appreciate any suggestions. Again, leave a comment down below if you'd like to see anything in particular for this area. In terms of the detailing I'm doing, it's pretty bare bones. I just wanted to add a little bit of a retaining wall just to kind of square off this area. Yeah, I might come back later, but also I don't think this is a super important area to detail, just because no one's really going to be using this space. It's more just important that it looks cool from an elevated position, which I think it does. So yeah, last thing I do is I kind of mark off this area that I mentioned earlier is going to be used for some city facilities. Yeah, that's it for this episode. So hopefully I'll see you in the next one. Bye.